Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Learning Arabic Oral Pronunciation. Today we'll talk about parts of speech in the Arabic language. We'll talk about them in a general form, we'll give you an overview on them, we'll make you know about them, and trust me, if you knew them really well, you will be able to speak in Arabic confidently, naturally, and in natural and on a normal pace. So let's start by knowing them. But you have to know that parts of speech in the Arabic language are nouns, verbs, and prepositions. So let's start. So let's start by nouns. We have nouns, could be human, which means in Arabic insan, human, animal, which means hayawan, plant, which means nabat, inanimate object, which means gamat. So it can be human, insan, or animal, hayawan, or plant, nabat, or inanimate object, gamat. So let's start by talking about each in details. We'll start by humans. We have here females like Soha, so as a female name, Layla, okay, Ahmed, names of a masculine one or a man, okay, Ismail, okay. Soha, Layla, Ahmed, Ismail are names of humans. You can also talk about you can refer to a father or a mother as a noun, okay, but we will talk about general form of a noun, okay. We have here animals as fil, which means an elephant, and in Arabic we don't say we don't have an indefinite article. If a noun is not defined, we don't say any article before it. We just say it naked, like that one. Zarafa, which means a giraffe. Asad, which means a lion. Nimr, which means a tiger. Okay. The plants, as basilla, or usually known or commonly known as basilla, which means peas. Fasolia, which means beans. Carnab or crumb, which means a cabbage. Basinjan, which means eggplant or aubergine, whatever you know about. Finally we have inanimate objects as qalam, which means a pen. Kurasa, which means a notebook. Tawila, which means a table. Kursi, which means a chair. So these are the nouns, okay, the main forms of a noun. If we wanted to study the noun, we must have series which will talk about nouns. As nouns, I can, you know, it's not about these things. These are not the whole nouns in the whole universe. So you know what I mean, okay, but these are the main ones. So let's move on to the verbs. But you have to know first that how do you know the noun? Okay, you are not a native Arabic speaker. Okay, so I'll just tell you that if you translated the word from Arabic into English, okay, and its meaning gave a noun, or it's not gave a noun. Mean if you translated the word and found that it meant the meaning of a noun, okay, then you know it's a noun. Okay, for example, if you translated up into father, father is a noun, so you know that this word is a noun, and so on. Okay, we move on to the verbs. Okay, so let's start by knowing how do you know the verb. Also by the same way, if you translated the word in Arabic into English and found its meaning to be a verb, the meaning of a verb in your language, then this word must mean a verb. But I'm talking about the English, because I know about that the English, it means about the English, and I think that this happens also in other languages. Okay, so we have here three forms of a verb in the Arabic language. We have the past tense or al-fa'l al-madi, the present tense or al-fa'l al-mudara, the imperative. Okay, whatever you wrote the imperative in the F or VE, okay, both means al-fa'l al-amr in Arabic. Okay, so we have past tense, present tense, and imperative. These are the main forms of the verb in the whole Arabic language. Okay, so we'll give you clues so that you know, or can, when you read the word in Arabic, you recognize it as a verb in your language. Okay, so you see here, if the verb started with ta or ya, okay, these two letters. Okay, we have here, as you know, that this tense is the present tense, as the word ya'kul and ta'kul. Ya'kul means he eats, and ta'kul means she eats. Okay, if the verb started by ta or ya. Okay, but you have to note that the letter ta we mentioned before is not a clue to that you can guarantee that the verb is always in the present form. The verb can be in the past form of the verb, okay, in some cases, if the origin of the verb starts with the ta, as in these cases, تغافل, تشارك, تقاسم, okay, تغافل and تشارك and تقاسم. These are the origins, the verbs in their origins or in their simplest form. So this simplest form all originally starts by ta, okay? So we use them as they are to express the past form of a verb, okay? So تغافل and تشارك and تقاسم also means the past form, okay? If you want to make it in the present form, you have to add letters so as to make it or to change it into the present form, okay? So what is the translation of these verbs? تغافل, so as you to know them, means to forget about something. تشارك means shared something. And تقاسم means shared something by dividing it into two halves. And this is the difference between تشارك and تقاسم. تشارك means only shared something. It mustn't be by dividing into two forms or into two halves. But تقاسم means that you divided the thing or you want to divide into two halves and you shared it. Okay? Okay. The last form of a verb, the verb in the imperative form. So how do you know that the verb is in the imperative form? Usually if the verb in the imperative form starts by letter alif, as if'al, which means do, irkud, which means run, iqfiz, which means jump. These are the verbs in the imperative form that starts by alif. But you have to be careful. Not on all cases, okay? You have to see forms like kul means eat and qum means stand. These are imperative forms of the verbs, but they don't start by alif, okay? So the secret recipe that you translate the words from the Arabic language into the English language, and you can recognize from the translation whether the verb is in the present form, the past form, or in the imperative form. Also, there is future form, but the future form is is derived from the present form of a verb, so we don't consider it as a new form in the language. Okay, we move on to the prepositions. Prepositions means حروف الجر. Okay, we have here an important note that there are many types of prepositions, not only huruf al-jar. Okay, huruf al-jar are the most famous ones. Okay, yeah, you have to note here. Okay, that the prepositions mean when if you translated them generally, it means huruf al-jar. However, in the Arabic language, huruf al-jar are the most famous types of the prepositions. Okay, there are many types of the prepositions. So, we'll mention the most frequently used prepositions in the Arabic language. There are more, but these are the most common ones, and these what we teach our children in the school. They may learn others when they grow up and become the secondary schooler or something, but they usually learn these. And these are the most and common ones. So we have here min, which means from, ila, which means to, an, which means about, ala, which means on or over, fi, which means in, ba, which means by or with, the letter ba only. If we added it to a noun, it becomes a preposition. So these all are added to nouns. So when they are added to noun, they are called prepositions. Kaf, which means as, lam, which means to. Min, ila, an, ala, fi, ba, kaf, lam. These are the most common used prepositions. We'll talk about them in a separate video. It's time. All you have to know about them. So some notes: ba can be replaced by the word wasitat, okay, as biminchar, which equals biwasitat minchar. All the two ones means with a soul. So if you want to replace the preposition ba by a word and means the same meaning, you can add the word biwasitat. Lam equals ila, which means to. And if you recognize that ila or lam both means to, okay, in some cases they have the same usage. In some cases they have the same usage, as ila al-madrasa, lil madrasa, which means to the school. So you have to know that this equal this in the pronunciation, in the writing of the form, but you have to know something about the writing. Lil madrasa equals this lam, the word lam, okay, plus the word al madrasa, as here ila plus the word al madrasa or the noun al madrasa. So you have to know about more about that. If we had this word li al madrasa, okay, so if we wrote it like that, lam, and then added the alif, and then added lam, and then like that one. If we wrote it the same, you have here ila al madras. So if we added the lam and wrote the same word without it changing, this will happen. Okay, lil madrasa, lam, okay, plus the word al madrasa. So this is difficult in pronunciation. It's difficult to pronounce the word like that form. You have to know li al-madrasa. Li al-madrasa. So it's difficult in the pronunciation and difficult in writing, of course. So the right form is to write it like that. Lam plus lam. We omit the alif. We omit this one. And we wrote it like that. Li al-madrasa. Okay? Li al-madrasa. We will mention it when we talk about the prepositions in other videos. Okay, so how do we know the preposition? Our last question. Also, by translating the preposition from the Arabic into English, it will give the meaning of the preposition, and you know that it's the preposition. Okay, so clap your hand that you finished the video with us, and clap your hands if you managed to understand things about the Arabic and found that the Arabic is an easy language and it's just about the basics. If you know the basics, you'll go on in the language and you may be able to talk confidently and naturally in easy and way to small steps if you manage to know the basics. So please clap you give us like and give us a comment if you liked our video. See you for another lesson. Bye.